Hello, everybody. I am Hole. No, I'm not Hole Puncher. I keep. I've said that so many times. I'm Teddy Jenkins, resident YouTube host of podcast. Hi. These are the filler co-hosts over here. Say hi, you two.
Hello.
Hello, I'm Lion.
Yep.
And I am
Yeah, he
Mexican.
lies all the time. I try to
Yeah,
make him
so.
stop, but he won't. He keeps on lying.
Yeah, and episode 1 is better than episode 7
Well,
of Star Wars.
thank you for ruining my introduction to what we're going to be talking about and reviewing and such. So you know what? Let's just get right into it. Let's get into
I was
the
just
okay.
saying that to piss people off.
Of course you were. Now, okay. This is going to be a two-part review, all right, of this whole thing. Everybody understand that?
Yes,
I'm telling
sir.
the I'm addressing the audience and my two co-host plebes.
Don't call me a plebe.
I just made a whole thing before this podcast about human perception is reality. Anyway, so first part is going to be non-spoilers. Second part is going to be spoilers. All right? Everybody got that?
Yeah, don't spoil that.
Yes.
Okay, great. So let's talk about it. What'd you guys think of it? Lion, you didn't actually
Thought it
see
was,
it. You're just gonna
but
listen and observe.
yeah, I really didn't care to see the movie.
You
Hate me
should
if you
have.
want.
Okay, you should have. You should have. Okay, you know what? I'll say this. You are not a true Star Wars fan because you
Excuse me?
because a true Star Wars fan would have been at least curious enough to go see it.
I've seen enough.
No, you
Trust
haven't.
me.
No, you haven't. You haven't. Okay, now, Ian, what do you think? What did you think of it? I'm curious on
I
your
thought it was a
thoughts.
pretty good movie. I saw like when I was a lot younger, I saw a couple of the original Star Wars movies. I forgot all of them though because I was really young when I saw them, and I never actually rewatched all the episodes. And then I saw the new one pretty recently. I thought it was pretty good.
All right.
I can't really compare it to the old ones though, since I don't really remember them. But everything about it was good. There's nothing that I could say I disliked.
All right. I gotcha. Yeah.
What do you think about it?
I thought it was good. I thought it was. Here's the thing. A lot of people might hate me about this for this. Lion, you're definitely gonna hate this. This could be for me the greatest Star Wars movie so far.
I agree, because it's the only one I've seen that I remember.
In all honesty. Now, here's the thing. I think my second, if I think it could be a tie between this one and Empire Strikes Back, because Empire Strikes Back has all the big, all the big lines and the most stuff happens in it, and has the cool lightsaber fight between Luke and Vader, and that sort of stuff happens. But I mean, in this one, I think. I think in this one, it really feels like the people making this understand this is one of the most important franchises to ever exist. Like, I really felt like everything was handled super carefully. And, like,
I think
you know what I mean, Ian?
of
Go, would you
course it
agree?
was it was directed by it was directed by J.J. Abrams, right?
Yeah, it was.
Or am I wrong?
Which, okay, I gotta say, he's a fantastic director. He really is. After seeing this movie and seeing the Star Trek movies, I know a lot of people didn't necessarily like the Star Trek movies, but
I
I
actually
thought
really loved the Star Trek movies.
I did too. I thought they were good.
Yeah.
A bunch of people want to say, like, oh, Star Trek Into Darkness was a ripoff of Wrath of Khan. It kind of is in many ways, but that's not necessarily a terrible thing. Like, okay, for
No,
instance,
it's not.
many people about this new Star Wars movie would say it rips off a lot of stuff from New Hope. I think it's more of homages. We will get into specifics in the spoiler review, but I thought it just it, if you think about it, is it really a terrible thing if it's homaging to to A New Hope? Like, isn't that a good thing? Rather than, many people
Well,
dislike the prequels because they were so far off from, the original Star Wars trilogy. So isn't it better that it's more similar to, it's like, do you want it to be more different or do you want it to be the same kind of,
honestly, honestly, it really boils down to preference.
But I agree.
In my opinion, the reason I am upset with it being a basic ripoff of A New Hope is not because, in a way, this doesn't make sense, but in a way, I am mad because both it is a ripoff of A New Hope. And
before you say anything, I would like to say you have not seen this movie. I would like to say that first. He has not seen this movie once again.
I've read enough.
You can't say that. You can't say that about anything. You can't say, I've read enough. You can't go online and be like, I've read enough about being poor to understand what it's like.
I've done my research.
I spiritually am poor because I've read so much about poor people. You know, like some of it's, you gotta really...
I'm just saying that I've done my research. I've formed my own opinion of it.
I suppose I can see that, but you still should see the movie when it comes out on DVD or go see it, while it's in theaters.
Yeah, I think eventually I'm going to go do that.
I'm going to go do that. Eventually. You're still mad about the prequels, aren't you?
Me?
Still...
No, I really liked the prequels. My favorite was
Holy cow. Okay.
My favorite was Revenge of the Sith.
I don't get you. How can you say this?
You don't get me?
How can you say, okay, Ian, tell me you're with me on this, that it's insane that he's saying, I mean, I get that you're not a diehard Star Wars fan, but you saw the prequel movies, didn't you? Did you see the prequel movies when they came out?
I also thought The Phantom Menace was really awesome because Liam Neeson.
Let Ian speak.
Liam Neeson!
Okay.
Wait, was the prequel, the one you just said, is that the one that just came out?
No, the prequels are the ones with, Hayden Christensen and Ewan McGregor, and everybody's young, and, before...
If I did see them, I would have been too young to remember.
Okay. Well, they're horrible movies.
So you basically
movies.
Just asked him for nothing.
But listen, in my opinion, my humble opinion... The prequels are terrible.
Everyone's got an opinion.
The prequels are absolutely terrible, and I don't get how you like
them. I don't hate on people because of their opinion.
I know. I'm not hating on you. I'm just saying I think your opinion is insane.
I'm just saying. Well, I'm saying that you don't have to say that your opinion is an opinion.
You're one of those.
I'm saying
you're
that
one of those,
I get.
You know what? I figured out the kind of guy you are. You're that guy who always has to be politically correct, don't you? Don't you?
Actually,
you just love political correctness.
No. I like being the good guy. That's what I like.
You realize that that's everyone's answer, though. That's everyone's, what are we talking about anymore? We're not talking about Star Wars anymore. We're talking about, lives. Nobody cares about that in entertainment.
Especially yours. That was a joke, I swear.
Well,
a moment of silence.
Let everyone know to go hate Lion forever. What was the name of your YouTube channel again?
Lion, just Lion, straight up. Lion. You're probably not gonna be able to find it.
Yeah, probably not. I challenge everyone, if they really dislike this guy, make sure to find it and just destroy him on the comments. Oh. That's the one YouTube video that you have. Okay, I'm sorry. Just, I can't be mean. Anyway, can we... Okay, let's just get back to Star Wars.
I love you too, Hole Puncher.
No.
I mean, Teddy.
No. That's... No.
Yes.
No. Yes, Never speak of us in a sentence... The two of our names in a sentence ever again.
You're very, very mean.
I don't care. Anyway. Anyway. Okay. So, Ian, since you're the only other one that's seen this movie, what else caught your eye about the movie that you thought was that you liked or disliked, but without giving spoilers away?
One thing that I liked about the movie was
Speak up.
like compared to the other previous movies. Like, does it have to be compared to the previous movies?
No, I'm just
Or
curious
just
about what
it...
you thought of it as a movie in general. What did you
All
think?
right.
What would,
I
if you could.
liked the I really liked the what would it be CGI, I guess. Like with
Well,
the
okay, I gotta say,
what's that
okay,
humongous ship?
that's one thing that I liked about this movie is that there was very, very little CGI. You know it? Because
But what was
the.
that?
Which flying. Well, we'll get
Oh, when
into
it's
which one was
directed.
the
When it's
one
directed
that
by J.J. Abrams. When it's directed by J.J. Abrams, it is really surprising that there isn't, like, CGI in it.
Okay, I will say this, there's only two totally CGI characters in this entire movie, and they don't look amazing. They look good, but it's not, outstanding or anything. You can tell them apart from the other characters. All the other characters in this movie are practical
Yeah.
creatures, which is really astounding because there's like robots that like junk, like all sorts of weird stuff. That's just I was just like, wow, that's a real thing. Like somebody made that. And it's I
Yeah.
think that's the thing that is so good about the original trilogy is that you can go back and watch those movies, and most of it was practical since they didn't have much CGI back then. And you can
Right.
kind of just and it lets you appreciate it more, and also it holds up better over time. Whereas, okay, if you go back and watch the prequels now, there's so much CGI, and it's so it was good back then, but now it just looks like a cartoon for all intents and purposes. I mean, all the clone
Yeah,
troopers in the
like
prequel movies are all CGI, so it's but this is one of those things where it's like you'll be able to watch this, years later and still like it and enjoy it, and you won't be like, man, that looked much better when I saw it in 2015.
yeah.
I mean, it'll hold up, I think. I think it'll really hold up, except for the two CGI characters that I mentioned, which we'll talk about them later. What were you going to say?
But like how many more movies are there still going to be? Like there's still going to be like a ton more, right?
Okay,
So
now.
maybe
All
oh wait,
right.
no, it's tied to what we're talking about. It's like with the CGI, since there's still like many more years for these movies to come, so wouldn't the CGI, like, don't you think it would get a lot better, or do you think it would stay pretty much the same as in this previous movie?
I don't think they'll add more CGI characters. I think it'll probably stay about this same. Well, as we saw from
Like
the
I
movie, there is one main character that will be returning who we is fully CGI, and he didn't look amazing, but I'm sure that maybe it'll be the CGI will be much better, or for him it could get worse. I don't know. It really only time will tell. However, about your
Yeah,
question
because
on how many more movies they're planning on doing, Disney has said they're planning to make at least 40 more years of Star Wars movies. 40.
40 more
40.
years.
By
Oh,
the way,
God.
Ian, if you can turn up your mic volume, because you're a bit quiet.
Oh, yeah, no problem. Yeah, I got it. One sec.
All right.
40
40
years.
years. They said that potentially it could. Oh, those fans that you mentioned are back.
Are they back, actually?
They are
Oh, man.
back. I don't know what happened. Oh boy.
Man, wait.
That's why you get a
Now.
noise. That's
Okay.
why you get a noise canceling microphone.
It
Noise
actually is.
canceling.
I have it set to like it doesn't pick up stuff behind me. It only has it so it picks up stuff in front of me. I don't know why I shouldn't even touch anything. Okay, well now I made it quieter. Is it better now?
Yeah, it's fine. Yeah, it's good now.
My laptop's gonna get like stupidly hot though.
It's pretty good.
It's okay.
Yeah. But so, what were we talking about? Oh yeah, 40
we
more
years. We got too caught up in his mic.
Yeah, yeah, 40 more years of Star Wars. So yeah, what do you guys think about the fact that there's gonna be 40 more years of Star Wars, at minimum?
A lot, too much.
But okay, let me ask you this:
room
is it
for,
really,
like,
is it really too much? Like, think about
honestly?
It.
Honestly,
for some people, I think it would be.
Many people, it will be. It could. I don't see Star Wars though just getting unpopular though in 40 years. I just really hope
that there's no true disappointments. Like,
I don't 40 years there will be a bad Star Wars movie again. There will be a bad Star Wars movie.
Yeah.
There's no doubt. It has to happen.
I guarantee you that it's going to be some sort of musical that Disney decided was going to be a good idea.
No. Oh, because okay, here's the thing. I know a lot of people dislike Disney. But they've done so much great stuff. Don't hate on Disney. I mean, okay, everything Marvel, if you like a single Marvel movie, that's because of Disney. You know, like that's true. Disney money.
Any Marvel movie?
Any one of the Marvel movies. Yeah. You have to thank Disney.
Any one of the,
cuz that's Disney money
any one
going
of the
into
current,
that.
Any one of the current Marvel
okay, if
movies.
You, okay, fine. You, if you liked the, I don't know, the Incredible Hulk from like 1990 or whatever, then you can't thank Disney. Is that what you want me to say? Okay.
That was in 1972, actually.
I really don't care. If you like the Lou Ferrigno TV show, you know what? Just keep on hating on Disney because they took that away
really
from
you. I really loved that.
I don't care. I care even less about that. I care even less about your
and
opinion
it
about
stopped,
that.
It stopped because Bill Bixby died, not because of Disney.
Awesome. Just beautiful. Beautiful. What the heck happened with this? Okay. Hang on. Sorry, the Gang Beasts crashed. Hang on. I'm loading back into it.
Are you playing Gang Beasts by yourself?
Yes, I am.
I keep thinking you guys are saying...
It lets me do the podcast very easily. Anyway,
I keep thinking you're saying gay beasts, not gay
beasts. Dude, that would be a horrible, horrible monstrosity of a game. I'm telling you right now.
Like favorite game.
Like penis cloning simulator.
Oh, please shut up before I kill you. I will. And I'm, okay. I'm not afraid to do it either.
I'm sorry, Lord Teddy.
And don't call me that either, or else I'll kill you more. Anyway, okay, so...
I'll kill you till you're dead.
Yeah, I'll kill you after you're dead. Anyway, okay. Can we please get back to Star Wars? I just want to talk about Star Wars. I just wanted to do this because I love Star Wars. Okay.
Triggered.
Okay. Everybody.
Gang Beast Star Wars update.
That would be awesome. Lightsabers for all of them.
Let's get to the spoilers. I'm interested to hear these.
Okay. We might as well get to the spoilers. Now, if you have not seen Star Wars, which you should have, unlike some people, then...
Oh, gee.
A, either go see it now, or don't, and, you know, just be like, I don't care. Spoilers. Hit them with me. Hit me with them. Not hit them with... I don't know what I said before. Anyway.
He's very confused, Teddy.
I am right now. I'm a blue squishy wrestler right now, so in this game. So Anyway, okay. My brain is dying right now from you guys.
Yeah, we have given you brain cancer.
Feels like it. By the way, no cancer jokes, please. Anyway, okay, spoilers for Star Wars. Okay, Lion, shut up. Ian, talk. Spoilers. What did you think of it? Just say, you can say anything about the Star Wars movie now that you want. Ian, stop laughing. I didn't give you permission to laugh. Now let me ask you this: do you laugh this much when you're watching any of my other videos?
I don't know what's making me laugh this hard though.
Yeah.
I can tell you what's making me laugh.
Okay.
Let's just continue on with this before Ian, the audience thinks we're like a bunch of idiots.
Calm yourself. They already think you're a bunch of idiots. Now calm down. Bring your chill levels to maximum.
All right, it's on maximum.
Okay, good. All right, so Ian, Lion, shut up. Ian, what did you think of the movie? Just talking about anything that you liked about it specifically. What did you think? Well, let's go character by character. How about that? We'll just talk about each of the main characters in it. How about that? That sound good? Everybody?
Sounds fine.
All right. Okay. You sound a bit too chill. Maybe bring it down just a notch.
You're being very demanding.
Yeah, I know. I don't care. Hey. I don't care about what you like or dislike about the demands. All I care about is that you obey. Anyway, okay, so...
Man, you're sounding really liberal over here.
Okay, yeah, I know. Don't say that. I dislike liberals. I hate political correctness. I dislike Hillary Clinton. Okay?
And okay, Obama. Enough of political stuff. We are getting very off track.
I know. Anyway.
Better than them.
Anyway.
Donald Trump.
Wait, what about Donald Trump?
Better than them. Better them than Donald Trump.
Is it really though? Okay, we'll okay, you know what? We'll have I'm planning on a new
we'll have a separate
show.
Conversation.
No, I'm planning on a new show called Sunday Drives, where on Sunday I upload this video where in Sleeping Dogs I just drive through town and we just talk about any single topic we want. It can be anything. So one of the first ones we will do will be like Donald Trump. And just our opinions of him. And we will all be respectful and kind. And people in the comments will do the same.
I really doubt that as far as the comments go, but
I have to believe.
It's YouTube.
I have to believe, okay?
Is there going to say one?
Believe
Squishy Man,
respect.
Go over the railing. Thank you. Goodbye. Okay.
Is there going to say one thing? Just one thing.
Okay. One thing.
I live in Canada, and I would like it if he didn't build a big wall between Canada and America, because I like going down there.
Okay. He's not going to build a wall blocking Canada, okay? Everybody needs to... You know what? One thing I got to say about Donald Trump, all right? Okay, this is the only thing I'll say. People like Donald Trump. I know the internet is all like, everybody hates Donald Trump. There's a lot of people that like Donald Trump. So everybody needs to stop. Everybody needs to stop. I kind of do too in many ways. We'll talk about it more specifically later. This is a podcast about freaking Star Wars, so let's talk about Star Wars now.
This
I'll
is
hope that he's not
in
the next Star Wars movie.
Now, Ian, what did you think of Finn? Of Finn, the character.
Well, he was black.
Yes. This is one of those times when I do like political correctness, just so everybody knows. Let's not refer to him as the black dude.
The only other black dude other than Lando and Mace
true.
Windu.
That is very true. I forgot about Mace Windu. Anyway.
He's like my favorite Jedi.
How? I don't get that. I don't get that at all. Anyway, okay.
Because he is Samuel L. Jackson.
Now that I do like. Mace Windu.
And did...
Okay.
He was supposed to get a blue lightsaber, but in the beginning, he asked George Lucas
to give him
a purple.
Listen, that purple lightsaber is the thing that makes him really cool. Now, okay, we're not talking about the prequel. We're not talking about Sam Jackson. We're not talking about Mace Windu. We're talking about The Force Awakens. And right now, we're talking about Finn, who doesn't have a last name yet. Now.
I really liked Finn.
You didn't see the movie, so you don't get
too.
To speak.
Maybe sure, saw him in the trailer.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah.
Now, Ian, what did you think about Finn?
I think he's a good actor.
I think he was a very good actor. He's played by John Boyega, I believe is his name. He's actually British, which you would not be able to tell at all if you watched this movie.
Yeah, a lot of them seemed British.
A lot of them did kind of seem like very theater actors, you know what I mean? very,
yeah,
that kind of, you know, very theater. Like they've done a lot of theater. I don't know what I'm saying anymore, but I'm trying.
They have a lot of experience.
They definitely have a lot of experience, especially Ray, which we'll talk about in a few minutes.
Yes,
she is very, very talented. I think that she'll probably be the next like Jennifer Lawrence. I can definitely see.
Yeah.
So Finn, I thought he was very, very interesting. What did you think about the fact that he was not the Jedi, like it was very heavily advertised? Were you surprised by? Were you really surprised by that? Because I really was.
That he's not a. Wait, hold on. A Jedi. What is that?
Are you freaking kidding me?
Don't toy with me. Don't toy with me. There are people watching this, and they're looking for our opinions, and you are giving nothing but garbage. You just lost 5 years
for me saying that.
I probably have.
We have done nothing but talk for like 5 minutes and then wander off the topic for like 20.
Gosh, I can't believe Gangbeast crashed again. Gangbeast freaking crashed.
0.3.0, a little bit buggy.
Yeah.
Because Gangbeast hates you.
I can tell. Anyway, okay. Anyway. So, Ian, what did you think about the fact... Okay, so I should tell Lion this. So, Lion, did you knew that Finn isn't the Jedi like it's advertised. Did you
know
that? Okay. What did you think about that?
I love
that?
The part where... Traitor!
Oh, yeah.
That was my most favorite part. Where he like whips out his baton and he spins it around like he's a freaking cheerleader.
That's a good part.
That was very interesting because so are we supposed to think that they knew each other or that he was just a dude who was like, "Hey, you're a traitor," like which seems
weird. I'm pretty sure it's a little bit of both.
Like he
was the janitor, and like, he was like sweeping one day, and then he was like, "Oh, hey, you're the janitor on the Death Star," or.
No, but remember when they like they're back in like that big, McCullough station, and he's on like the little ship, and he's the only one in like that little ship, and then that
guy.
Okay,
you can't call everything the little ship. There's a lot of little ships in this. You can't describe everything as being. Hey, you remember when they're on the big ship, then they get on the little ship, and then they go to that planet, and then they all have a big fight, and then. If you say everything like that, everybody's gonna not have any clue what you're talking about. Now,
remember that one guy from that one movie?
Yeah, I know, right? Anyway, okay.
Oh, gee, that's
Ian,
not vague
can you,
at all.
Can you try describing it, making things a little bit more specific, so that people can follow what you're saying?
So, the big shit.
Ian, I'm serious. I'm asking you to be serious here for this one thing. Like, literally.
That is a tall order.
Okay, both of you, I've never asked in either of you for anything. And one day, I just asked you if you could be on this podcast. So, can you please do this one thing for me? Just this one. You can just never do anything for me ever again. And that would be fine.
No, cool. I enjoy being a good friend. I'll do other things.
Okay. These podcasts are cool.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, you're a very good host.
Thank you. I try. Okay, so let's just be serious, all right? Let's see. I'm serious though. I won't make any jokes. You guys won't make any jokes. How about that? Okay? We'll try. Like we will legitimately try this. Cuz I want to do this, okay?
So he's over there chuckling like a jackanape.
No, okay. Okay. No, for real. Jokes end now, all right?
I'm not even saying anything.
I know.
Being serious.
Okay. All right, Kent, I'm serious. Can everybody please not be 5 years old for 5 minutes?
We need a less serious topic, because with less serious topics, we're actually more serious, believe it or not.
Star Wars is too humorous.
I gotta say, that's actually something that we can actually talk about. There's a lot of humor in this movie. There's a lot of jokes. Yeah. Like, okay.
Isn't the robot the new Jar Jar Binks?
I heard some people say that. He's not. He's not at all. I thought he was very... Okay, we talked about Finn a little bit. Let's talk about... How about we talk about BB-8 since you guys brought him up?
Let's talk about Kylo Ren.
He's cool.
No, we're going to talk about BB-8 now. So, Ian, you thought he was cool? Thought he was cool?
Yeah. He moves.
He, you know, he's all practical too. He's no, there's no CGI on that at all.
Yeah, because I've seen like little mini versions of him.
Yeah. Oh, and like, yeah, and like, and like, what's it called, the place where they have all the massage chairs, Brookstone.
Like, I don't know, because like our school has one of those, and they were rolling them around.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Yeah.
that's how I know.
He provided some good comic relief without being annoying or anything, and he was useful because he was like, he's basically R2-D2. Like, that's basically what he was.
Yeah.
Like, I won't lie, that's, he was the next, he was supposed to be like the next R2-D2, which is fine because he fits the role very well for a droid.
He does.
Okay, why don't we talk about, we'll do Kylo Ren since Lion brought it up. What did you guys think of Kylo Ren as a villain?
I think he's desperately trying to be Darth Vader.
Well, he is, because in the movie, you see that everywhere. He worships Darth Vader's helmet. I mean, which is really weird. What did you guys think about the fact that he is Han Solo's son?
I honestly think that is a brilliant twist.
I think it is. I think it's not much of a twist when you find out about it, because it's sort of a twist. It's brought up a bit anticlimactic because it's just Grand Leader Snoke, who is the kind of new Emperor type character, saying, and, you know, your father is Han Solo, basically is what he says. And I remember everybody in the movie theater going, what?
And if you've read
you have exciting books, movie theaters.
That's like not his only son.
Yeah, in the expanded universe, which technically is no longer canon.
That's stupid.
Well,
those are some of the best stories I've ever read.
That is true, but you know, they got to put some regulations on it because they're a company. You got to accept the fact that Disney is a company, and they got to do company things.
You got to do what they got to do.
Yeah, it pretty much.
Okay, Arnold Schwarzenegger.
Well, okay, so I thought he was a good villain. I think, though, the thing about him that I most didn't like was the fact that he did not have nearly as much presence as Darth Vader. Like, he had very little gravitas to him, which I think probably, though, that that's just because it's Darth Vader and you can't really ever live up to somebody of it being a villain as great as Darth Vader, you know?
Right.
Like, that's what I'm trying to say. Hey, I'm going to be the next Tom Hanks. You just can't do that. Like, you can't just go and be the next Tom Hanks. Wishful
thinking at its worst.
Yeah. Yeah, it really is. It absolutely is. I did like, however, that in the movie they show him as being a really childish guy. Like, he's not mature at all. Because you can see that every time that, you know, something bad happens, he's got to, like...
Well, of course he's a Sith.
Well, as we kind of learn in the movie, he's technically not a Sith, because the Sith don't exist anymore since...
He's with the dark side, and he follows the teachings of the Sith.
But you know what I mean? Like Darth Vader was mature and focused. Kylo Ren, I thought, was immature and very just kind of filled with rage and anger and just didn't really know what to do with it. Like, he's just kind of lashing out at everything that angers him.
He lets his emotions rule him.
That is true. Which one could say, which you could say, that's what the dark side is all about. You know, is letting everything, out.
Yeah, they say to use your anger, but not to let it rule you, because that leaves room for weakness.
Yeah. Which I think, and at the end, near the end when he kills Han Solo, I think that that was him trying to let go of his weakness. I think he thought that, you know, I'm drawn to the light, which he says in the movie. And so he thought, this is my dad's fault. It's because of him that I want to go back to light side. But in order, if I want to be strong, I need to let go of my attachments to my weakness, basically. I need to cut my weakness off. So I think he thought that was Han Solo, and so he killed him in the movie, as we saw. So since we've talked about Kylo Ren, why don't we talk about Rey, who is the is actually the protagonist of this movie, which I never would have guessed. Not in a million years.
I would have kind of thought it'd be Finn.
I really thought it, because they show Finn with the lightsaber every single time. So you think, okay, he's the Jedi. Got it. But no, it's... And I gotta say, she is way cooler of a Jedi than Luke Skywalker was. Because Luke Skywalker, not a very good Jedi, I gotta say, in the original movies. He really doesn't do a whole lot, I felt. He wasn't a very powerful Jedi, I thought. But in this, it's like, no, Rey and Kylo Ren, they know what's up. They're pretty tough Jedi and Sith. Well, if you don't want to officially... Technically, Kylo Ren is part of the Knights of Ren, as it's now called. But I mean, you know, he's...
Kind of like the Knights of Revan?
Yeah, kind of like that. But they're basically Sith. He's basically a Sith. But so I thought Ren. Okay, I gotta say, oh gosh, what's her name? Somebody look up the actress who played Rey right now.
I got it.
But I'll talk about that the actor and actress in a second. I it was real surprise because I think Ian, I'm curious if you
Daisy had this, Ridley.
Daisy Ridley is a fantastic actress. Because, I mean, she just killed it in this movie. You know? Wouldn't you agree, Ian?
I think she's very good looking.
Okay. I think so, thank too. You. That's a much better answer, Lion. People can actually respect
you. Do you
people
think
people
the same?
Can actually respect you now.
I think she is. I think she has a good face for that character.
Okay.
Very, very good one. Yeah,
that's a fine answer. Anyway, that's you made it like, okay, I'll accept that. You know what, if you talk like that the rest of the podcast, I'm cool with that. Anyway, okay. I think she's a fantastic actress, and I think that she's a really great character, because in many ways she mimics Luke, which I think that there are many theories going around as to whose daughter is she, because her parents left her on Jakku, as we see in the movie. And I think that she's probably Luke's daughter. What did you think, Ian, as to who her parents were?
I don't know. I've only seen this one movie, and I...
Come on, you gotta have thought something about who it was that her parents were that left her on Jakku. I mean...
We need to talk about Finn and Poe's bromance.
We will talk about that in a second, because that is... Okay, okay.
We need to make that our main focus.
Okay, first, no. First, Rey. Okay, what were you going to say, Ian?
Okay, thirdly, after we do the second thing, I want to talk about...
We're going to talk about everything.
No, but this is something I don't know if you'd get to. There's a specific thing that the movie kind of messes up on, that I want to talk about after the second thing.
Okay, good. We'll talk about that. Right. Anyway, so Rey, what did you, Ian, think of her as a character? Do you think that
really
she
good?
Had a good arc, a good story arc, good character development, and such?
She's good with everything.
Awesome. I'm gonna be the guy who says the specific stuff. I thought it was very good that she in many ways reminded me of Luke Skywalker, because she was on a dusty old sand planet where nothing really happens and she doesn't really like her life there. And then one day, you know, she meets somebody or something, meaning BB-8. And then kind of her whole world sort of just changes, and she's really excited by it, and it's really amazing because it's like, wow, I never realized you can just go anywhere in the galaxy and have all these crazy adventures, which I imagine kind of all of us would think if we all of a sudden were just in Star Wars. You know,
I'd actually prefer to be in the world of Mass Effect.
I will just, you just did that. I know that.
That was a joke.
I know. I'll let it slide. But
like, okay. It's funny that I have to clarify that it's a joke.
I know. It was a joke. but so I thought she was a good character. I thought the actress did a great job with her. I think Daisy Ridley will be the next Jennifer Lawrence, though, due to the fact that she kind of has that sort of, I don't know, you know what I mean? The same kind of appeal and the same kind of, like, vibe. I get the same kind of vibe from her acting as I do Jennifer Lawrence. Does that make sense? You know what I mean? Like, she seems to have that sort of, like, I could see her being in a, you know, a young adult novel turned movie series like Hunger Games. We've talked enough about Rey. She was great. I think it was interesting having a female Jedi in a movie, which I'm totally fine with that, and I think it's really cool. I just hope it's not they didn't do that because, oh, we need to have a girl be a main character in this movie. You know, I hope they didn't do it
for the Weibo Finn.
Really? I kind of did too. I was like, yeah. I like him. I just hope they're not putting him in this because he's a black guy and we need to have a black guy as a main character. Like, you know, I'm fine with having that's why I really don't like it when in like superhero stuff they change the race of a character. Like they make Superman black or something like that. Cuz like Just make an interesting new character. You don't have to turn Superman black.
Like,
no one ever asked.
That's stupid.
Yeah, like just,
you know, what would be better?
What
if they turned Superman Asian?
And he had like a Superman karate chop move. You'd just make it even more ridiculous on top of the idea.
No. He instead of working at a newspaper place, he'd be working at a university, doing everyone's calculus homework.
I thought you were about to say he'll be working in a sweatshop, and I was like, don't go there.
Oh my god.
Or a dry cleaning place.
I was... Or he's like a drug lord for the Yakuza or something. I don't know. I feel like that's the kind of joke you'd make, but I was wrong.
No.
Anyway,
I'm not that cruel.
Okay, great. Anyway, so I guess we can move on now to Poe Dameron, played by Oscar Isaac, who, okay, after seeing him in this movie, I think he's also a fantastic actor, and he's going to be playing Apocalypse in the next X-Men movie, which will be really great to see him in and stuff. Anyway, I just said and stuff. I can't believe I said that in a movie review. But yeah, I what did you guys think about him? Because he wasn't in the movie a huge amount, but he definitely played his part. I mean, as a, you know, in the movie, he was definitely there when he needed to be and wasn't overused or anything. So, go ahead.
His bromance with Finn.
Okay, I gotta say, in the beginning of that movie, they do a great job of establishing these two guys as best friends, and it's amazing. Mm-hmm. It's just like
their bromance is the best. They need to make a story just of their bromance,
of them just hanging out, going on adventures. That I would actually love to see that.
That would be an amazing movie.
Just the two of them, like, how cool. I'm thinking that in the next movie they might do that, since Finn is in the medical bay healing up and Rey's gone, that it might be like Rey's doing her own thing and the rest of the movie is like Kylo Ren training and then Finn and Poe doing their own kind of, you know, we gotta go blow up a fourth Death Star type thing.
And then, you know, Kylo Ren comes along and he's like, traitor!
Yeah, just out of nowhere, just kind of like, you know, hey, I just wanted to remind you,
traitor!
Traitor! Yeah, traitor. Yeah. Also, I gotta say, it was I think everybody was really surprised when Kylo Ren took off his helmet for the first time, and he was just a normal dude. Like, he didn't have, he wasn't all scarred up, which he gets scarred up by the end of the movie because he has a giant lightsaber slash across his face, which, I gotta say, I would be real mad if somebody did that to me. Just, like, made a huge...
I'm gonna be crying.
Oh, of course, in real life, everyone would be crying, but because it's Star Wars, you know, he's just gonna be like, I'll get you for this.
Of course, he's with the dark side.
Yeah, you know, he's crying, not cool. How funny would it be if he's actually like crying on the inside and he's telling himself like, Sith don't cry, Sith don't cry. Like, you know what happened, what Grand Leader Snoke did to me last time I cried. He just slapped me real hard across the face, and I was like, ow. And then if I cried more, he just kept slapping me. Okay,
there's
he's definitely
one more thing. There's an emo Kylo Ren account on Twitter.
I've seen that and I've followed it.
That is the best thing I've ever seen concerning Star Wars.
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. Okay, so who are we talking about? We're talking about Poe Dameron, that's right. Okay, Poe Dameron and Finn are amazing together. The scene where they break out and they're just like, just being bros, just hanging out. And the scene where, Finn blows up the turret and then goes, did you see that? Did you see that? And he's like, I saw that, man. I saw that. It's so cool how you did that. And it was, I mean, they really had great chemistry in this movie. Really, really great chemistry. And they did a great job of establishing their friendship early on perfectly. You know, like, from the very get-go, I was like, these guys have known each other for, like, 10 years. You know, they went to college together. They're, like, best friends for life, you know? Even though they've known each other for, like, 5 minutes. Like, it makes you feel
enthusiastic about this, even more than I am.
No, I have to be. It's part of my job. But yeah.
No. I get it, but it's very unnecessary.
Okay. Maybe it is, but I gotta say, I love this movie. I loved this movie, and I think everyone should go see it. I mean, really, it's if you like Star Wars, you should see this movie just because you like Star Wars. I mean, that's the only thing.
I'm gonna send you this picture.
No, don't send me anything.
I'm gonna send you this picture later. Okay, and it is a picture of Kylo Ren's face on Edward Scissorhands, and instead of scissors, he's got lightsabers for fingers.
That would be amazing. Ian, I think we've talked about all the main big characters.
Yeah.
Well, we haven't talked about the original. We'll talk about the original cast returning after we talk about Ian's thing. What is it, Ian, that you had an issue
with? This is a point that actually my dad brought up, and I thought I was pretty smart, or he was pretty smart when he brought this up. So, remember that part when it's called Death Star?
It's called, the official name is Star Killer Base, but it's basically
Star Killer.
So we'll just call it Star Killer Base. Yeah.
You know how it's blowing up all those other planets, right?
Yeah. Blows up like 6 planets.
And you know how those planets are all in like different like systems, right?
Yeah.
How was that one that it when the Death Star when it was whatever it's called when it was shooting the planets? How come people from other planets could see the explosion of the other planet happening even if it was so many light years away? Like it would have taken
So you're saying, like, how is it that the light reached their eyes even though it's far away?
Yeah, like, wouldn't if it taken years?
That's very true. Okay, if you want to know the science of how Star Wars doesn't make sense, I honestly suggest go follow Neil deGrasse Tyson. Because after the Star Wars movie actually came out, he just posted a whole bunch of tweets about how Star Wars doesn't scientifically make any sense. So he asked questions like that, like, well, you know, like Starkiller Base really couldn't do that, or couldn't use a sun to fire lasers at a planet and blow them up. But I mean, part of it, you just got to accept it's Star Wars, and you just got to suspend your disbelief a little bit, which, I mean, you know, that's, you kind of have to deal with pretty much all movies, in all honesty.
I don't like the movie anymore because it's not realistic.
Yeah, okay, I would hate anyone who said that. Because no movie's realistic. You know what? If you say that The Dark Knight Rises is a realistic movie, or The Dark Knight is a realistic movie, it's not. You know why? Because the idea... You know what? I hate people who say... I don't hate these people, but I'm upset at them. That say, I don't like The Dark Knight because it wasn't realistic enough, or this didn't make sense. You got to realize, the premise of the movie is about a rich dude dressing up as a bat and going and beating up people. You signed up for that. So prepare to suspend your disbelief and things to not make sense. Because it's about a rich dude beating up bad people in a bat costume.
Yeah, I don't like Donald Trump because he's not PC.
Oh, gosh. Okay, we will definitely talk about Donald Trump later. Lion, are you still there?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm here.
You were very quiet.
I'm just silently laughing, trying not to, like, break the serious tone of this conversation.
Okay, good. So, all right, now why don't we talk about the original cast returning? And Lion, I'm curious on your opinion of this because you're so opinionated. What did you guys think of them? What did you guys think of them? Do you guys think it was a good idea bringing all the original cast back on?
I actually, to be honest, I thought it was a really good idea. I had hoped that they wouldn't use somebody else. I thought it was a really good idea that they did that.
Yeah, I think the...
Because, well, you know, it makes it feel more special.
I think it also helps you slowly ease into these new characters. You know what I mean? I think the purpose of bringing them back is that it's like, okay, you know those characters y'all loved? Here they are. And also, they're going to start... You know, like okay, I think that all of the original characters will be dead by the end of this trilogy. I think that Leia and Luke will die. Yeah. Because
and that's the point that I was going to bring up. They better use Harrison Ford before he dies.
Yeah. Because, well, you know, like, Harrison Ford has said in interviews before that he had wished that he had died in Return of the Jedi because he thought I would serve as a more... important character. I would serve a much more important role that way. Which I gotta say, it's when he dies, everybody is like crying in the movie theater. I mean, everybody goes,
yeah,
like, you know, just everybody flips out. I mean, same thing. There are multiple flip out moments that happen in this movie. Many moments where you just like flip out and are like, oh my gosh, that actually just happened. Han Solo, I think, dying is the second most flip-out moment. There is another flip-out moment that I will bring up in a second. What did you guys think of Harrison, the acting in all of them? So, Harrison Ford, I thought was good. I thought he did great.
He needs to add a bit more cockiness.
That's a joke. That's a joke.
He needs that old, that old Han Solo feel.
Well, I gotta say,
where he's like, don't get cocky, kid.
Well, I gotta say, and you can't disagree with me on this line because you haven't seen the movie.
Don't get cocky, kid.
He fits right back into the role of Han Solo perfectly. He is Han Solo.
Of course he is. He's Harrison.
Yeah. No, but what I mean is that he didn't. You know, he knew exactly how to act as Han Solo after all these years. You know, like, imagine returning to a...
He did mess up.
Yeah, I mean, imagine returning to a role that you haven't played in, like, what, 40 years? I mean, you know, you'd think that they would show some difficulty getting back into the swing of things. But he, you know, I mean, he nails it, I think. Except...
He does.
Except for the points when he's with Carrie Fisher playing Leia again, and they're like having romantic, just talking like husband and wife, and it's like kind of
gross.
I wouldn't say that, but I would say that's when their acting is at the worst. because he doesn't play the romantic, you know, dad kind of guy. You know, he plays the smirking, cocky smuggler guy who's always snarky and is like, this is ridiculous and dumb and just, why is all this happening? You know, and he does that most of the movie. But I got to say, when he's being all like, hey, Leia, sorry, I haven't been home in like 30 years. And she's like, yeah, well, thanks a lot. You know, I've had to like deal with the fact that my son's evil for 30 years with the whole alone. I mean, I think that's probably the worst acting parts in the movie. Go ahead.
Pretty much is Han comes home and she's like, yeah, the fridge is open. Go ahead.
Yeah, that's very
like
much.
Like it's nothing.
But I think you got to realize that, and she says this in the movie, that they kind of just get back in the swing of things immediately after seeing one another, because like if you look at the original trilogy, they kind of do that anyway. You know, like Han and Leia will be apart for a while, and then they'll come back, and then they'll just be exactly where they left off. You know, they always.
I just find that comical.
It's very comical. I mean, I think it's comical.
I find it very humorous.
I think that's the point of it, though. I think it's supposed to be funny and kind of. I think it's supposed to be banter. I mean, that's basically what it is. It's just banter, basically. Okay, so Carrie Fisher is Princess Leia. Again, General Leia. But no, not General Leia, General Organa. General Leia Organa. Since Organa is her last name. Anyway, I think she was the worst actor in this movie, maybe. Did you guys think so? Because, I mean...
I don't remember.
I kind of felt that she was just sort of...
I'm literally skipping through this movie right now as we speak.
I gotta say, I felt that she was kind of not the best. Although, necessarily...
I'm sorry. That was my fault. Continue.
Okay, although it may not necessarily... Did you guys think that she was really a great actor when she was in the original trilogy movies? All the original movies?
I think she was exaggerated.
That might be it. It might also be that she was supposed to be a princess, and she played that part. You know,
I'm not going to confirm or deny that I got the movie from a bay that has pirates in it.
Oh,
I will not tolerate that here.
But I am now condemning a bay with pirates
for being a bad person.
What? With a bay full of pirates?
Let the record show that I condemn his actions completely. Okay.
Well, okay.
I'm not going to spend time talking about this. This is a podcast, and I got to run it. So, Mark Hamill as Luke Skywalker is in this movie for about 15 seconds, and then. That's it. He just literally stares at the camera while Rey is like, hey, I think you dropped this lightsaber a couple years ago into a giant cloud when your hand got chopped off. And then it's like, oh, huh. He just stares there with that kind of like, huh, look, you know? And then the movie ends. And so, if we want to based how well his acting was off of that stare, I'd give it a 7 out of 10 for that stare. For that stare alone, 7 out of 10. Okay. What else is there that there is to talk about? I suppose we haven't talked much about the bad guys, have we?
I have to step
we talked
for
about
a
Kylo
minute.
Ren.
BRB.
Okay. We talked a little bit about Kylo Ren. We have not talked, however, about... Let's see.
The baton twirling stormtrooper.
The baton twirling stormtrooper. He was fine. He served his purpose.
I thought he was very enthusiastic. I thought he was very enthusiastic about his job.
I thought it was also kind of strange that he just picks out Finn out of all the people that are shooting,
and well, he's like, oh hey, he's got a lightsaber. I want to be fair and use my baton. You know,
I think that's though like the soldier kind of thing to do though. I think that's what it wanted to show, that like
pretty much
those two guys are soldiers.
Take out the strongest one.
Well, I think it was a matter of honor too. You know, like he felt like I should be the one to take this guy out in you know, real combat because of what he's done. You know, I think it was that sort of thing where he felt like I should be the one to take this guy out because he betrayed everybody at the First Order.
Right.
Traitor.
So yeah, yeah, traitor. What did you guys think of Hux, the dude who is the not friend of Kylo, the like his brother basically is what it feels like. They have the red hair and wears the suit and is real angry.
He's a doofus.
He kind of is.
I don't remember who that is.
Well, that shows how important his role was. What did you guys think about Grand Leader Snoke?
I don't know who that is either.
That's the big CGI dude that's like 50 feet tall.
Oh,
that guy.
He seems really menacing.
And I think he's not actually. I'm pretty sure he's not actually 50 feet tall, and because it's a hologram, which we find out later.
But his hologram's 50 feet tall.
Yeah, I think that. Which, okay, let me ask you this. If you could make a hologram of yourself and that's how you spoke to people, would you make it 50 feet tall or would you just make it normal size?
Normal size.
I would too. So it's kind of weird that he's like, I want people to look up to me through a hologram, even though in real life, I heard somebody make a joke of, what if he's actually like 2 inches tall? Like in reality, he's just 2 inches tall, and he just does that. He just did that so that way he would seem more menacing to people. By the way, that guy is played by Andy Serkis, famously known for his roles as
the voice.
The motion capture stuff was done by Andy Serkis, famously known for his roles as Gollum and Caesar from the Planet of the Apes movies. I gotta say, that guy is one heck of an actor. Really is.
Yeah.
He always impresses me whenever he plays his roles.
Me too.
Anyway, I suppose just get into some. Was there anything else that you guys want to talk about? Any theories?
I'm out.
I want to talk about why there are so many memes of Finn and that one stormtrooper where he's just like, traitor.
Are there really a bunch of memes? Like, I haven't seen those.
Yes, like my favorite one is this guy who's got like all these veins popping out of his head, and he's got like a stormtrooper helmet on, and it's like in the caption is, "When you haven't called someone a traitor in 5 minutes."
He has the helmet on, how do you know the veins are popping out of his head?
Well, I saw the original picture, and you can still see the veins out of his neck.
Oh, by the way, okay,
maybe they're rolling on his neck.
There is one character though that that we didn't talk about, which is Captain Phasma, the chrome stormtrooper.
Oh, that guy.
The chrome stormtrooper. Oh, and it's a girl. Yeah. It's a girl, by the way. It's not a
guy. I think she got killed because of the compactor.
Well, she's actually supposed to be in the next movie, which makes me think she must.
Okay, well then she didn't die.
Yeah, there's no way she died, because. I mean, they never showed her dying, which means, and you know, I think though that she will serve a much bigger purpose in the next movie, you know, because they don't show her very much in this one, and she's kind of just there as like the, almost like Boba Fett in some ways, you know, she kind of reminded me of Boba Fett in a little bit, just because she was kind of like had the real cool armor and obviously has some skill that never gets shown off. But yeah, I think that might be the end of the podcast, guys.
Right.
Is this the end?
Well, it was a good podcast.
Yes, it was, but is this the end? This is not the end of Star Wars.
Not until next week. Oh. I thought you were talking about the next podcast.
Oh, yeah, well, that too. Well, we'll have another podcast next week. Thank you guys for watching. We really appreciate it. I'm sorry if these two insulted. I don't know. I just hope they didn't do anything that made you mad.
Insulted Donald Trump.
Yeah. Insulted Donald Trump. And
Donald Trump will be the new Reagan.
Okay, I gotta say this. I gotta say this. What if he is?
Donald Trump will be the best president in the history of mankind.
What if he is, though? Think. I'm just saying.
Episode 3 is better than episode 6 of Star Wars.
I'm just saying this. I don't want to leave everybody with this thought. What if Donald Trump is a fantastic president and defeats ISIS and, like, does everything that he says he's going to do? Like, what if he does?
You're going to defeat all the Doubtful. Mexicans and Canadians, too. Yeah.
Doubtful.
But what, if, he does? Anyway, thank you for watching. I am Teddy Jenkins.
I'm Lion.
And I am X to the Pert.
No, you're Ian, because that's how everyone has referred to you on this entire podcast.
I'm also Ian.
Yeah. Goodbye.